It's do or die for the president's massive health care reform.
Health care reform in trouble.
The Obama health care plan hits an enormous speed bump.
The new warning, it will increase government spending, not cut it.
The head of the Congressional Budget Office came out this week. He said the plans he's looked at so far don't do the job. In fact, the cost of health care might go up. Have you guys botched this job so far?
No, I'm surprised that the Congressional Budget Office had these views and didn't share them with the Ways and Means Committee before we concluded our work. But it's clear that they're working with different assumptions than the White House and the Congress is. But we got to fix this terrible problem that we have in our country, and we will do it.
This is the legislative process, and this is what normally happens. I think we are making good progress. There's been a lot of progress.
A lot of progress, but not a lot of consensus yet on how to pay for it.
None of this is easy. There's a reason why this hasn't happened in 50 years, and we're making a lot of progress.
This is a work in progress. The good news is the House and Senate are actively working and share the president's goal that overall costs have to come down for everyone. So they have an initial report on one of the initial bills that says in the long term, this doesn't bend the cost curve enough. The president has a proposal that he hopes will be incorporated, where MedPAC, an independent group of providers, will help to lower the Medicare costs long term. But he's very committed to this, and I think it will be part of the package going forward.
I think the single most important thing that's missing from the legislation at this point is our proposal for an independent commission of doctors to help the policymaking process be more flexible, lead to higher quality and lower costs over time.
Why
that is
that
a big game changer. People are reacting too much to the ebb and flow of what's happening on a day-to-day basis. Again, this hasn't happened in 50 years for a reason. It's complicated. Legislative process is working. I think people are sort of reaching judgment about who's going to win the marathon based on who's ahead at like mile 19. Not a good way of judging things. We're making a lot of progress.
Will both the House and Senate meet the president's deadline and pass separate health care measures before they go on August recess?
That is the goal.
And what do you think of the chances?
I think the chances are high.
Will the president meet his deadline?
He's very clearly urging the House and Senate to stay at the table and work. They're working very hard. We think this can be done. The House and Senate are on track and on time. And
he's urging, but not demanding.
Well, he isn't a member of the House or the Senate. He's saying this is an important issue. It may be the single most important issue to get our economy back on track. And the status quo cannot work. It doesn't work. It's bankrupting this country.
But it looks like that deadline could slip.
Well, hopefully they'll get it done before the August recess.
Is that deadline now off the table?
No, it's still the goal. And
still the president's insistence?
We think we can make that. We're working towards that.
The president said this was his deadline. Now you say it's his goal. That's a softening.
Well, we want to get it done by August, by the August recess, and we think we can.
Is the president going to get a bill out of the House and Senate by the August recess?
Well, I don't think he ought to get the particular bills that we've seen out of either the House or the Senate before August, because they're really not the right way to go. I mean, what's going on here, David, is perfectly clear. This is the same kind of rush and spend strategy we saw on the stimulus bill.
The president really wants these bills before the recess so they can be dealt with after the recess. Is this all going too fast?
Well, I think so. I mean, you're talking about one-sixth of the American economy. You're talking about myriad problems here. You're talking about people who are all over the map as far as what they really want to do. And I think there's a really good reason why the president wants to do it. He knows he can't sell it if the debate lasts very long, because it is so expensive and costly. It's become so political. The House bill's total partisan bill. The help committee in the Senate bill is total partisan bill.
The fact that it's not bipartisan is not because we Democrats don't want to have a bipartisan bill. We don't have any Republican answer. It's easy to say what you don't like about this bill, but it'd be far more constructive if we had something to work on.
This is a bill that shouldn't pass at any point, either before the August recess or later in the year. What we need to come up with is a truly bipartisan proposal.
Will they get what they're working on now, though? Do you think they'll get it passed?
Well, I certainly hope not. I don't think this particular measure ought to pass either the House or the Senate, because it's not good for the country.
There are some who are advocating delay simply because they don't have anything to put on the table. The typical Washington bureaucratic game of, if you don't have a better alternative, just delay in the hope that that kills something, is partly what's playing out here. There are those who are advocating delay just as a desperation move to try to kill this.